I'm Hannah. Most of you that are watching this video might have already seen the first few videos of me, but I'm going to summarize what's been happening. I've been here for 3 months in Israel, and I have received a no-exit court order by my family, by my parents. I am an Israeli. I'm also a Canadian. I've lived most of my life in Canada, and I have a Canadian citizenship. My children have Canadian citizenships. My child was conceived there. I'm 5 months pregnant. When I was looking for help, because no one here in Israel had been able to help me up until now, a few days ago I reached a woman over the internet, an amazing woman whose name is Mariana Zizi. And she had gotten to know very, very well someone who is a journalist here in Israel. So since then, they helped me, and my kids. They had no reason other than just to help a human being. There's a many good people here in Israel. The legal system is corrupt. A lot of things are corrupt here. From what I see now, from what I learn now, literally see and experience. But the people are good, you know, and willing to help, and they have helped me so far through an underground organization. And I am safe. My children are safe with me right now. However, I can't stay in Israel much longer. I most likely will be going to Palestinian land soon, and it sounds completely ridiculous that for an Israeli, for a Jewish woman, to have to run away from Israel. When I came here, I never would have thought in a million years that I would be actually saying this. Taking my children to somewhere where I've been taught, you know, that is not safe, that I would feel much safer bringing them into than safe to stay here. I want to thank everyone who has listened to my story. I know that it sounds unbelievable. I still, to this day, am a little shocked by it. But it's true, it's happening. I have legal papers to show that it's happening. I have no reason to make this kind of story up. Not the first one. But hopefully I will get the story out so that I will get help with my children. With your help, please. Continue your support. I'm so grateful for it. The least I can say is thank you so much for the kind words that Marianne has shared with me. Thank you for sharing, tweeting, and emailing. You have been amazing. Every time I speak to Marianne, she tells me what's going on, because I don't have much internet right now. So
actually, you're kind of running to the Palestinian Authority. Why is that?
Because I have to find a way to leave and to come back to Canada, and I can't do it from Israel. I'm pregnant, 5 months pregnant. I'm scared to have a baby born here in Israel.
So I feel like my only... So actually you'd rather have the baby in the Palestinian Authority than Israel?
At this point, yes. Because I am Israeli, and I feel like I'm being punished for being Israeli, for having a Tu'dat Zehut. I cannot leave here. It's not enough I have a Canadian citizenship. Because I'm Israeli, it's enough for somebody to do this to me and my family.
You have been spoken to the Canadian consulier, right?
Yes, the embassy.
What did they tell you?
So a lot of people have asked me a lot of my friends have asked me, a lot of you have asked me, why doesn't the Canadian embassy help? Well, it's not that the Canadian embassy doesn't feel for me, as they say, and wish that they can help, but so far they say that it's that they don't have the power over the Israeli power in order to make me exit here. I have to go through the legal system, and the legal system will probably put me through hell, and I don't even guarantee that I'm going to get away with, but to be released of this as soon. And I am very pregnant. I have 4 months left, and I want this baby born away from Israel. If it has to be on Palestinian land, then it has to be. I want to go back to Toronto. That's my home. I want my children, my baby, and us to grow up there. I want to be back home. Please, whoever is watching this, who is willing to help in any way, you know, I'm already so grateful for the response, but action these days, any day, is much more helpful than just talk. So I intend, if and hopefully I will get away from this horror, I intend to also help other people who may have been put through what I have been through. Unfortunately, Israelis are also going through this. The people who were born and raised here and live here, there's horrible, horrible things going on here. But again, I want to stress that Israeli people are not bad. The Israeli system is very, very, very corrupt.
You know, many people said that they just don't believe that the welfare is coming and taking children away from the parents with no reason. What is your experience with that?
The welfare people never even the social service, children protection services here. I'm sorry, it's a joke. I felt unsafe just even talking to them on the phone, but when I met them, they threatened to take my children away, all because of something my parents wrote, without getting my story, without actually getting to know me, without getting to know anything about me from Toronto. That's, you know, I've been here only two months at the time that they contacted me. How would they possibly know me? And I'm scared that all their threats are true, because actually, through this underground organization, I've learned that they do horrible, horrible, unspoken things to children and their families. And this is the reason why I need to get out. This is the reason why I don't want anyone to take my children away from me. I've done nothing wrong in Israel. I've done nothing wrong in Canada. The only crime I've done, if you call it a crime, is trust my parents here in Israel.
Okay, so we will keep on escorting you with the story, and keep on filming you, and let everybody know what's going on with you. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much.